Lefe with 6, Mombasa with 2, while Kajiado and Kwale have 1 each. Out of the 38 cases, 21 are male, while 16 are female. Tracing of contacts for the 38 confirmed cases is ongoing. The total number of close contacts that we have so far been monitoring stands at 1,141. Out of this number, 163 have been discharged after completing the mandatory 14-day follow-up period. Currently, our teams are monitoring 978 close contacts. We have 3 individuals who have been admitted at Bagathi Hospital awaiting test results. To date, we have now tested 833 persons for the disease. As we informed you, from tomorrow, we shall embark on a mass testing for those persons who arrived in the country last week and are currently under mandatory quarantine. This will be done in line with the World Health Organization guidelines on testing for the virus. Due to the seriousness of the coronavirus disease and its potential strain on our healthcare resources, it has been deemed necessary for the government to institute mandatory quarantine for all those who have tested positive and their contacts. Once you have been identified as a contact to a patient who has tested positive, the Ministry of Health shall send its officials to your house to escort you to a quarantine facility. The purpose of this exercise is to have close monitoring of your well-being so as to safeguard your health and particularly safeguard that of your family and your friends at large. At this juncture, I'm appealing to our people to make it very unnecessary for them to engage with the police by staying at home and observing the directives given. I'm also urging our police that people should be treated humanely. However, let me state that we are not going to pull back on the enforcement measures. We have so far instituted, and this will only make things worse if we do so in the fight against the disease. I know that there are issues being raised about the curfew which started last night. However, I will not deal with matters of operations, curfew operations here, because the concerned agencies will be addressing you regarding that matter. On the part of the Health Ministry, I am asking the police to offer assistance wherever it is needed by our people, especially with nurses, with doctors, public health workers, wherever they are. I'm referring to the medical personnel, who include all those people, but also other essential services. And I'm asking for the police to assist them in carrying out their work, even if it means using their vehicles to do so. For me, these are the people I rely on as a cabinet minister, as a cabinet secretary for health, to assist me in this enormous task. Let us respect and support them. Once again, I appeal to Kenyans to make it difficult, if not impossible, for the police to come in contact with them by just doing the right thing, staying disciplined and staying at home at the hours given. And today, I saw somebody send me a number. I would like to share this number with you and make it our clarion call. The number 65959 is our curfew number, should be a rallying call for all of us at this time. 65959. And the time, it is actually the time. It is 6 o'clock, 59 minutes and 59 seconds. At that time, call your friend, call your family, call your colleagues, find out whether they are at home. And that is the best way of diminishing the issues that are arising and the issues that are being raised by Wananchi. It was inevitable that on a first day, there were going to be issues and there were going to be mishaps. But my hope and prayer is that going forward, particularly effective a day like today, when there is no work, then we hope that these will be matters of the past. At the same time, I want to make a special appeal to all employers, all those with members of staff, ministries, government officials, that we must give people time to leave work early enough so that they can be in their homes before the curfew time. And as I said before, at this time, we are all called to sacrifice. There is no choice. And therefore, I am appealing to employers to please allow people to leave on time so that they can be in their homes by 7 p.m. The trend that we have seen here in terms of increasing the incomes of increasing numbers is not a healthy one. And I want to warn Kenyans that this is where our focus should be. It is important to remember that all the 38 Kenyans we are talking about come from one village, they come from one family, they come from one estate or somewhere within Kenya. And it is important to appreciate that the over 1,000 contacts we are talking about are also going to be with another 1,000 contacts somewhere along the line. This is how this disease spreads. This is how people in Italy and elsewhere are dying in the thousands per day. Per day. And if we want to save Kenyans, if we want to avoid the experiences that other countries are experiencing, we must do what those who have succeeded in addressing the disease have done. And what they have done is social distancing, is disciplining themselves, is staying at home when they are told to stay at home, and doing all the other hygiene measures, taking all the other hygiene measures that we have taken. It is important, fellow Kenyans, that we follow these rules. Otherwise, ahead will be extremely stark times. Let us cooperate. Let us work together towards avoiding a total and complete breakout of this disease. I thank you, ladies and gentlemen.